Hello everyone, a warm welcome to Grade Up. I am Niharika Pinto and I welcome you all to the Grade Up MBA Conclave 2021. I can see many students have already joined the session. Do share it with your friends so that many more students can join in. We are about to begin a very interesting session. Chetan Bhagat will be joining us any moment now. For those who have joined Grade Up for the first time today, Grade Up helps more than 2.5 crore exam aspirants prepare for various competitive exams. Grade Up helps students prepare for MBA exams like CAT, ZAT, SNAP, live from the comfort of their home with live online courses taught by MBA industry veterans and 100 percentilers. For today's session, we are joined by a very special guest, a mechanical engineer from IIT Delhi and an MBA from India's most coveted institutes, the IIM Ahmedabad. He went on to work as an investment banker in Goldman Sachs and Deutsche Bank in Hong Kong and is now one of India's best-selling authors. Join me in welcoming none other than Chetan Bhagat. Hi, Chetan. Welcome to Grade Up.
Hi there. Thank you so much for having me, and on a very unique topic, which I really enjoy talking about, but I don't get a chance as much. So thank you for taking me back to my IIM days, sort of, because that's what we're going to do today.
Yes. So Chetan, you have written many books about your IIT Delhi journey, your life at IIMA, also about your personal life, that is your marriage with Anusha. So your readers know a lot about you as a person.
Too much.
Tell us something that the world does not know about Chetan Bhagat.
Okay. I mean, I'll tell you something which I'll tell you when you're going to ask me about the interview round of IIM.
I will be.
So there, remind me of this. I will pakka tell you something which I've not told anyone, or like very few people know.
Okay. I'll park this question for them.
Yes. What was something you did in an interview that I think led to my final selection? But anyway, we'll talk about it. And like I said, that's not...
So after studying at IIT Delhi while you were doing your engineering, how come you decided to write the CAT and to do an MBA?
Yeah, so I was in IIT and I was doing engineering, and a lot of my friends and even I thought I'll be going to the US after IIT, do a master's in engineering and take that route, use IIT to go to the USA. But something happened during my summer training at IIT that changed me. I did my summer training at Cadbury's Chocolates. Don't ask me why. I mean, it is because I like chocolates a lot. But basically, I was not that serious, I guess, because a lot of my mechanical engineering batchmates, they were doing in Steel Authority of India Limited, Tata Steel, and L&T, and all these hardcore engineering kind of summer trainings they were doing to understand engineering. I took a engineering training. This is not even a marketing or an MBA training in Cadbury's, in the factory where chocolates are made. It's near Pune, a place called Tanegaon. It's a beautiful place. They have cows there from which the milk comes, the dairy milk chocolate that you have. And I worked in a chocolate factory for a long time. And I was obviously an engineering kind of, I was working on the packaging machines and all. But one day I saw they had a meeting in the factory, and some people drove down from Mumbai, which is where their corporate office was. And the marketing head of Cadbury's came. And he came in, I still remember the car. There was a car in India at that time. You are probably too young to remember it. But a car called Contessa, you know. And these were these really long. And if you look at it now, it won't look that great. But at that time, it looked like, wow, what a car, like such a long car. I remember this really tall, dashing man stepped out of the car wearing sunglasses. And I was like, who is he? Because none of us in the factory ever dressed like that or anything. I said, he's the marketing head of Cadbury's. He's the main thing, because chocolates are about marketing. I mean, you know, the brand and this, that. And he came to the meeting and it was like he owned the place. And I was like, how do you get that job? And they said that you have to do an MBA. You have to do an MBA to get that job. And the engineers are in the back end of the factory. Clearly, I was one of those people who liked the limelight a little bit, as has been shown later. So I thought, I want this job. And it seemed like a lot more fun to me too, because doing just engineering and repairing machines and things like that didn't seem as much fun. But thinking like, okay, what would make people buy something, or what would make people interested in your brand? That seemed very fascinating to me. So they said that you have to do an MBA, and the best place is IIMs to do it. So, and that's how I decided I don't want to go to the US. I want to come in a Contessa one day and like be like that man who was a Cadbury's. I had a poor, God bless him, he doesn't even know he ended up inspiring me and making me change the course of my life.
So I'm really inclined to ask you that, which car do you have now? So did you fulfill your dream of buying?
I'm not a big car person, you know, and I'm actually not a very big car person. That time I felt it nice to see that car, but I later on realized, like you know how many guys have their car collection and bike collection. I'm not that person. I do have a Mercedes. And that was also given to me by Mercedes because I did a work with them as a brand. So it's not a car I had to buy even finally. It was given to me as part of I thought I'll manage a brand and I'll go to a brand, but the brand wanted me because I became a brand myself. But yeah, I have a Mercedes now. Very nice. It's a good car. But like I said, it's 11 years old now. I'm not a big car person. I like Uber. I like Ola. I like the shared economy concept. I think that's nice. I just wish you could have better cars than that. But yeah, not a big car collection person. Just getting them serviced every year and all, my God, so painful.
So while you decided to do an MBA, you were a fresher. And
yes. You did not. Yeah, what you call like a first attempt, like straight, no work ex. Yes.
So how was that transition that you might have people in your batch who had work experience?
So, yeah, you know, I was very young. Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah, sorry, you wanted to finish that question?
Yeah. Also, do you advise students to take CAT as a fresher? How is the journey different for a fresher versus a person with work experience?
I'll tell you, I was very young. I mean, I was anyway young when I went to IIT. I was 21 when I went to IIM Ahmedabad, and I was 23 when I graduated. So I agree that it is a very young age in terms of doing an MBA because I had no real world experience, right? Apart from my internship at Cadbury's for 2 months where I was basically eating chocolate. So, I mean, but I thought, why not give it a try and why not see whether you get in or not? Because yes, work experience helps. Sometimes it will help you sit in an interview and talk about things. But if you've been doing a lot of things in college, like I used to write plays, I used to write articles, I used to take part in a lot of extracurricular, like cultural kind of activities, ran a newsletter, take part in the Rendezvous Festival in IIT. That's not work X, but it is X experience. It is some kind of a experience apart from books. And I think that can make you confident enough to talk and face an interview and do things like that. So I think that way it's okay. Also, you're kind of in student mode because IIT, I was in student mode. So you are studying anyway. You have a campus, you have a library. Whereas let's say you're working in a job, then you have a boss and you have projects and your assignment, and then you have to prepare for CAT at night. I think that may be difficult because the last year of engineering is actually much easier, especially if you have some flexibility in doing courses. So people, what they do is they keep that semester, which is the CAT preparation semester, they keep it light. They will take less courses of IIT or whatever. But at the same time, a lot of my own friends from IIT, my own people from my own college came after 2-3 years of WorkEx. And they became my batchmates then in IIM Ahmedabad. They were my seniors in IIT. They went out there. They came after 2 years. So they were my 2 year senior in IIT, but they were sitting in class with me now. So that has also happened. 5 year seniors have also come. So no harm done. It depends on what is available to you. If you get a great job, by all means, go for it. If you don't have a great job and you get into an MBA, go for that. I won't overthink it, is what I would say.
So what were the challenges that you faced during your preparation journey while preparing for CAT? Also, anything that, you know, aspirants should definitely keep in mind while they go into the CAT journey and they prepare for an MBA.
Yeah. And so I'm not being extra modest here, but because I'm from IIT and I know some serious whiz kids, you know, some kids who are like born so smart, they're just so smart, they get everything. I am not that guy. Okay. And the good thing is I'm aware of that. And I think it's very important to know your strengths and your weaknesses. I am a smart guy and I understand things, but at the same time, I'm not like so gifted that I look at something and I can just top an exam without preparing for it or just preparing. That's not me. I have to work. And it may not sound so fashionable, but yes, I have to put in the work. When I decided to prepare for this CAT exam, I had to, like I said, I had to make sure that first of all, you have to make sure that you don't have other things going on in your life, which are so mind boggling that you can't do this. So I took a lighter workload in IIT. I also maybe was okay with getting a lesser grade in my IIT courses in the final year, but then I think we didn't have online that much. We would have these fat books, we would have correspondent courses for, but it's the same thing. It's just online now, it's just more convenient. And I remember I said that what always in everything in life, actually what I've done is consistency. That is my strength. I can be consistent and I can keep at it. Every day, little bit, little bit, little bit, little bit, those tiny, tiny increments. And I knew that I'm not a genius, but I knew that I can go every day in the library before dinner, go and study for 2-3 hours, and then say that, okay, then I'll go to my hostel and eat. I'm not eating dinner till I finish this work. And then the reward is the dinner. So I think Punjabis link everything to food, which is leads to its own problems. But it was, I still remember that. And I would go to the library, and I would study for CAT at that time using those booklets. Sometimes you're taking mock tests. Sometimes you're doing just one section. Sometimes you're doing a topic. Being from IIT, it was, I do acknowledge that quant was simpler for me. And I think that is a problem for a lot of students who are not from the quant background. At the same time, English was not that simple for me sometimes. You know, like we were not used to doing things like that. And even though quant is a little bit simpler, it wasn't like I did my first mock test and I was like getting amazing scores. No, nothing like that. In fact, there were times where my scores came out very bad also. Sometimes they came out very fixed also. But consistency. The consistency for CAT was lesser, I would say, than IIT preparation. My IIT preparation, maybe I was much younger then. And I do also remember that I enjoyed studying for CAT more than IIT. IIT is very difficult. The pulleys and trigonometry. And it's like, it's very hard to enjoy it unless you're like a total nerd. Whereas in IIM, you still have the CAT still has some vocabulary sections and you'll read a nice passage and you'll do quick sums. It was still better, you know. And I remember towards the end, a lot of people, there was a section in the IIT library which became de facto the CAT preparation wing, because I would see the same students come there and we would use stopwatches at that time, like or a Casio watch or whatever, because we didn't have the phones where, like, you know, and then we would do our tests and all every day after day. So yeah, this is a very long-winded way of saying that it's consistency matters. I also remember the last 30 days, I would take a test every day, like something like that. It was like that, just testing. And then of course you see the mistakes, and you try to see, why did I make this mistake? Was it a careless mistake or was it something I don't understand? So again, consistency. That's how I've written books, one page at a time. That's how I've cleared IIT. That's how cleared I am. That's how I've, whenever I've managed to lose weight, I mean, sometimes I gain also, that is not a good thing. But the only time I've been able to lose weight is when I'm doing it consistently, not like a crash diet or something. That's with CAT. That's with everything in life. And that is what all the students here should understand. That if you are consistent, that's a very big weapon against geniuses, including that IIT genius who you are scared of.
So consistency is like the key of life.
I think so. Especially for big, big exams like this, which require vast preparation.
Yeah.